Hello students, welcome to NIRS Education Channel. Today let us start a new lesson from your Moments textbook. Name of the lesson is The Last Leap and it is written by O. Henry. Let's have a brief introduction about the lesson. It is autumn. The wind is blowing hard and it is raining heavily. All the leaves on an ivy creeper have fallen except one. Why doesn't the last leaf fall? It is autumn season. The wind is blowing hard and it is raining heavily. All the leaves on ivy creeper, all the leaves on ivy creeper have fallen except one. All the other leaves have fallen. Only one leaf left. Why doesn't the last leaf fall? Then why doesn't the last leaf fall? What is the reason for that? That thing we are going to see in this lesson. Now let us start the lesson. Sue and Jonesy, two young artists, shared a small flat. The flat was on the third story of an old house. Okay. Sue and Jonesy, both of them were young artists and they shared a small flat. The flat was on the third story of an old house. Jonesy fell very seriously ill in November. She had pneumonia. Jonesy fell very seriously ill in the month of November. She had pneumonia. Pneumonia means lung inflammation caused by bacterial or viral infection. Okay. She was suffering from pneumonia. She would lie in her bed without moving, just gazing out of the window. She was always lying on her bed without moving and she was gazing out of the window. Gazing means to stare intently or earnestly, see something constantly. Okay. She was gazing out of the window. Sue, her friend, became very worried. Seeing her condition, Sue became very sad. Okay. She sent for the doctor. Although he came every day, there was no change in Jonesy's condition. That's why she called a doctor. Sue called a doctor. Although doctor came every day, there was no change in Jonesy's condition. Doctor was coming almost every day, but there was no change in Jonesy's condition. One day, the doctor took Sue aside and asked her, "Is anything worrying Jonesy?" One day, doctor took Sue aside and he asked, "Is anything worrying Jonesy? Is she worrying about anything?" "No," replied Sue. "But why do you ask?" "No, I don't think so." "But why are you asking that one?" The doctor said, "Jonesy, it seems, has made up her mind that she is not going to get well. If she doesn't want to live, medicines will not help her." Then doctor said, "I think Jonesy has made up her mind, or she decided or convinced herself that she is not going to get well. She decided that she is not going to get well. If she doesn't want to live, medicines will not help her. If she doesn't want to live, if she doesn't have hope for her life, then medicines will not help her. Medicines are not going to save her. There is a saying that no poison can kill positive thinker and no medicine can save negative thinker. If she herself doesn't have that desire to live, then whatever medicine you give also, it is not useful. Like this, doctor said to Sue. Sue tried her best to make Jonesy take an interest in things around her. She talked about clothes and fashions, but Jonesy did not respond. Sue tried her best to make Jonesy take interest in things around her. She talked about different clothes, fashions. Fashions means style of manner. But Jonesy did not respond. She was talking about all those things in order to change the mind of Jonesy. But Jonesy did not respond. Jonesy continued to lie still on her bed. Sue brought her drawing board into Jonesy's room and started painting. Jonesy continued to lie still on her bed, and Sue brought her drawing board into Jonesy's room and started painting. Her intention was drawing the attention of Jonesy. To take Jonesy's mind off her illness, she whistled while working. So, in order to take Jonesy's mind off her illness, she whistled while working. Sue was whistling while she was painting. Suddenly, Sue heard Jonesy whisper something. She quickly rushed to the bed and heard Jonesy counting backwards. One day, suddenly, Sue heard Jonesy whisper something. She was telling something in a low voice. She quickly rushed to the bed and heard Jonesy counting backwards. Then Sue rushed to her bed, Jonesy's bed, and heard Jonesy counting backwards. She heard that Jonesy was counting backwards. She was looking out of the window and was saying 12. After some time, she whispered 11, then 10, then 9, 8, 7. Sue anxiously looked out of the window. She was looking out of the window and she was counting backwards. Earlier she told 12, after some time she said 11, after that 10, 9, 8, 7. Like that she was counting. Sue anxiously looked out of the window. She saw an old ivy creeper climbing halfway up the brick wall opposite their window. Then she saw an ivy creeper climbing halfway up the brick wall opposite their window. In the strong wind outside, the creeper was shedding its leaves. Outside, there was strong wind. Because of that, the creeper was shedding its leaves. The creeper was leaving off its leaves, dropping its leaves. "What is it, dear?" she asked. "Six," whispered Jonesy. "They are all falling faster now. 3 days ago, there were almost 100 leaves. There are only 5 left now," she said. "They are all falling faster now. Leaves are falling faster now. 3 days ago, there were almost 100 leaves. There are only 5 left now. Now only 5 leaves are left." "It is autumn," said Sue, and the leaves will fall. What is special about this? It is autumn season. Leaves will fall. It is not surprising thing, she said. When the last leaf falls, I will die, said Junsi with finality. I have known this for the last 3 days. Then she said, Junsi said, when the last leaf falls, I will die. She said with finality. Finality means in a decided manner. I have known this for last 3 days. For last 3 days, I have known about this. When the last leaf will fall, I am going to die, she said. Let us stop here. We shall continue in the next session. Thank you for watching.